Well met, first ban being Zeratul, and we are not prepared, banning Stitches.
What's with the Zeratul first bans now?
He does loads and loads of damage, quite simply, and his steals are ridiculous.
Still, but there hasn't been any changes to him, have there?
Nope, it's just indirect stuff. He is still good. He is still as good as he already was, and with Tychus out the way, one of the main assassins that he couldn't take down in one go is gone. So he is a lot better now. We're seeing him be removed because now Valor is the best assassin, and Zeratul kills Valor very quickly.
Okay. And what about just banning Brightwing?
We're seeing Brightwing banned a lot, but in this case, I think Zeratul is more important because Valor as an assassin is the first pick, and Stitches is just, we don't like Stitches. He's very annoying. It's going to be Stitches, Valor. It's going to usually be Stitches or Brightwing being banned. Zeratul is just sort of the fit-in situational thing.
Oh well. So we're probably going to go back into Tychus. Tychus, always standard ban.
Once he's back, anyway. He's no longer perma-banned.
Alright, so that's Brightwing for Well Met, and Arthas and Tassadar for We Are Not Prepared.
Yeah. And that's quite interesting, ignoring the first opportunity to get an assassin. But that does mean Well Met are in fact going to be able to pick up Valor first if that is what they choose to. Considering they've also removed some of Valor's biggest threats in the form of Zeratul with their ban. So that's what I expect to see. They've also removed the Polymorph, so they have the potential of taking Strafe.
That's a nice combination for Well Met.
Yeah, Well Met have been, for this entire time so far, taking their time with their picks.
Well, they do have a couple seconds.
And someone's saying, link to the multi-shot build, you literally take every multi-shot talent and then take battle momentum and you're pretty much sorted. Also execution, so that you do bonus damage to them once they're slowed. But yeah, the multi-shot build is much easier to do than you are sorted. And yep, we are seeing the Valor coming out, and the Muradin is going to be coming out for Well Met as well.
Ah, so it's going to be Nomi playing Muradin again?
I would assume so. Like I said, he is happy as Larry that he is now viable. And there we go. People are arguing over you whether you pick Blood for Blood or Executioner as the final talent for multi-shot build Valor.
Testingo is in there, I think.
Is better. Yeah, Testingo is there.
So he can probably sort it out for these guys.
Yeah. Listen to Testingo, guys. He knows what he's talking about. I miss watching him play. I haven't cast him in a long time.
That's true.
And Minix's just name was the most fantastic thing, because you can't say it outside of the way the Ascended Shieldmaster says it. Sergeant Hammer returning to the fight once again. Seeing her almost every game at this point. Mm-hmm. Like she was before the patch, she is just good. Huge damage, long range, it is nice.
Ooh, a noob as a possible counter to Valor here?
Yep, solid selection for that exact reason.
Yeah, Nazibo, exactly. I was just going to go into that. Now that Noob is out for We're Not Prepared, it's probably not going to be Nazibo for Well Met, even though I think they would have liked to see him and like to play him, but it's not going to happen. At least I doubt it.
Yeah, well Met could just throw everyone for a loop here and just pick up Ufa to just deny the support pick to We Are Not Prepared and just heal the hell out of Valor the entire time.
Well, what about Rhaegar? Rhaegar's still in there.
Rhaegar is still there, but he took some hard nerfs.
Really? Did he?
Yeah, I think he
did. Why is that? I mean, Rhaegar wasn't one of the...
I know he got changed. I can't remember if it was a nerf. It looked like his healing was nerfed a bit in the videos.
Mm-hmm. What about Stitches? From the way I read it, his Devour is now even stronger? Or...
Okay.
Did I completely misinterpret that?
His Devour is still pretty nice, but just pointing out here, Thrall has entered the fray for the first time.
Wow. Wait, so it's not messed up. They have Thrall in the selection.
Apparently. It's fine.
I thought it's Tychus.
No worries.
Okay, awesome. Alright, I've not seen him in action aside from the trailer, so I'm excited to see him.
Yep.
And he's an assassin, if I remember correctly, right?
Yes. very much an assassin. Some of the best burst in the game, thanks to Wind Fury. Like, the majority of the builds nowadays are based around the... Like, the most important parts of it is battle momentum to get that Wind Fury proc as soon as possible. You take the Sunder ult because it's just amazingly good. And you take the triple hit on Wind Fury on the final hit. At level, I believe that's 17. I'm struggling to find the patch notes. I have no idea where they keep them anymore.
Oh, Rainer. I'll just look on Reddit.
That's Triple Assassin. Oh yeah, that'll have it here. Why didn't I think of that? What am I doing? But yeah, Triple Assassin is pretty interesting. So they're going to be going for the all-in kind of damage here with because Thrall has to get in there to do his damage, really. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So it's going to be Thrall and Muradin in the front line and then Rainer and Valor in the back line, but that's still quite risky.
Yeah, but Rainer is a little bit of a beefier assassin, I think.
This is true. With his passive heal, he does do a bit more. And this is Garden of Terror. Having that clear is still pretty nice. Mm-hmm. And
so we'll have to see another assassin coming out if we're not prepared. And, well, what really viable assassins are still in the game right now? As Jainer finally... Oh, yeah, Feltzin.
Jainer got changed. I haven't really seen her...
But she didn't receive better way to get out of fights before level 13, right?
No, she didn't. She basically got her Q nerfed and her E buffed, and it's gonna be Malfurion's because they needed support. To be fair, they didn't have any.
But what about Uther?
Uther would have been nice, but I guess the AOE healing is a bit too much to go by. They're going for more of the American style here.
Hmm. Malfurion. Okay. I don't really see the massive combinations for We're Not Prepared, but okay. I do like Anubarak, to be honest. Anubarak and Hammer I really like. And they should be able to dish out some damage on the back lines there. Or well met.
Indeed. I cannot find these patch notes. I am just... I'm looking through Reddit. I've even just searched patch, and I've just got nothing. I've got videos and stuff, but... I cannot be bothered to watch through an entire video. If I was going to do that, I'd watch my own. So,
and we'd have to sit here for an hour.
Hey, found it. There we go.
Okay. Yep. Thanks for Testingo for stepping in. The reason we're not using the in-game draft system is because you can switch heroes later on. So it's just the random selection of who gets to pick first, and yeah, you don't really want your support player playing a different hero.
Yeah.
Alright, so there's going to be a 2-minute delay, and then we can get started here.
Yeah, so like you said, Gorge now does a lot more damage, mm-hmm. So which is why it was quite confusing to see the mile being taken. And what was the other person we were looking at that we thought changed?
Jaina. We wanted to check out Jaina.
Well, Jaina hasn't had much change other than her okay. W got her E got buffed, her R actually got buffed a bit. Okay. And Q got nerfed.
Who else?
Who was I looking at? It's someone in this game. I know it. But I cannot remember who for some reason. Oh my god, that's going to annoy me. Oh well.
I think Zeratul? Wasn't it Zeratul? We wanted to check if he had. No, wait, he didn't have any changes though.
No, he did get changed, but that was a general change to all cloaked characters.
And what is that?
Cloak now activates after being out of combat for 3 seconds up from 2.5.
Okay.
So yeah, I can't remember what it was. I spent all that time and I've completely forgotten what I was looking for, but oh well. Goody goody.
Okay, I'm gonna fix up my tea and I'll be right back.
Alright. So, draft has finished. We're just waiting for all players to ready up. Soke has asked for 2 minutes, and then we will be getting into the game as quick as possible. But yeah, someone pointed out Thrall of Wind Fury and Rainer Inspire. Rainer Inspire does give bonus attack speed, I believe. So that could be very cool. The map will be the Garden of Terror. And we will get this underway. There we go. People are readying up. And we can get this underway. 10 out of 10 players are ready. And hopefully we can get into the game as soon as possible. So let us wait for a second. Hello, teams. Let's get this underway. Someone leaking the draft phase. Oh, yes, the delay. Fantastic. I'm sorry. I found it in the end. I'm just really bad at searching for things. Ball is returning.
All right, I'm back.
Yep. No, they're ready. And finally, well, good timing.
Perfect timing. Let's do it. Map is Garden of Terror, and we have started loading into the game.
Yep, we have started loading into the game indeed. And this match will be well met versus We Are Not Prepared. Two quotes from actual Warcraft characters here, who I don't actually think I ever met in person in Warcraft.
Which one was that?
Warcraft lore. Ufa and Illidan. I don't think they actually ever met in person. They were two different storylines, really.
Okay.
Like, Ufa... spoilers, for those of you who haven't played Warcraft 3, the, like, 10-year-old game now at this point. actually, it's more than 10 years. God, that's an old game now.
Let's get started with the game before we do the spoilers. Okay, let's do it. On the left side, the blue team, a German team by the name of Well Met, and they have a lot of StarCraft 2 pros in there. For example, Nomi on Muradin. Hysterica is playing... who's that? Vala. Hasuops is playing Rainer. In the bot lane, we have Zake giving his premiere here on Thrall. And in top lane, Hiruki is playing Brightwing.
And on the right-hand side, in the red trunks, it is We Are Not Prepared. And we have Polator on the Malfurion. T-Darker on the Anubarak. Falcon is on the Sergeant Hammer. In the mid lane, it is Killer Chino. I'm assuming that's Chino.
Killer Chino.
On the Tastar. And it is Black Scorp is on the Arthas in the bottom lane.
I like that last one. Okay, we're not prep. Well, doesn't really fit in there.
Right, the names. Why you're doing that? Not much happening other than it is a party lane and top lane for We Are Not Prepared, and a bit of a roaming squad in the form of Valor and Rainer, which is interesting. For Well Met is now roaming up to the top lane just to try and counter this this party lane a little bit.
We'll have a closer look on Thrall here during the game. Rolling Thunder is his first talent choice here. Increases the Chain Lightning's range by 30% and gives him a little bit of mana left.
Yep, Thrall actually does have a couple of mana problems if you are spamming abilities, which you will want to be quite a lot. He is unlucky though, being set up against Arthas here is unfortunate, because Arthas with his AoE is going to make it very difficult for Sokei to really get involved here. But yeah, just really, if anyone could tell me if Ufa ever met Illidan, because as far as I'm aware, he died far earlier than that.
Yeah, he was the mentor of Arthas, wasn't he?
Yeah, and Arthas went evil and murdered him long before Illidan really even did anything. So, spoilers!
Okay.
For that 10-20-year-old game now. Right now, Sokei and Nomi have completely raided the seeds of We Are Not Prepared, and have taken control of that very quickly, but the party top lane for We Are Not Prepared is looking pretty convincing. They were able to get most of the seeds and are already starting on this Shambler.
Yep, Hiruki is scouting this out, so he knows, okay, they're going for that Shambler. And now Hysterica and Hasuops are joining the fray, but they really need all five heroes here if they want to contest that. Especially with Hammer in the back, dishing out the damage. And Darka really doing a good job here in the front lines, kind of guarding off Hasuops there on the left side. So they're gonna grab a lot of seats here, and that's already 60, 80, 70, oh, 80 seats going
the
way for We're Not Prepared.
Like, Black Scorp just got Vision of the Terror. They can see it's only half health, and we're seeing Tassadar and Anubarak heading down here to try and contest this. Black Scorp already taking a bit of preliminary damage, but in comes Killer Chino, and Darker looking for the opportunity to try and steal some of those seats. Sokei gets knocked up, there's the Envenom, but the heal from Brightwing and the shield will be enough to keep him alive. In comes Protator, and now we will see We Are Not Prepared attempt to steal the remainder of these seeds, and I believe what's left in here is easily enough for a Terra. Nomi, though, is just going to walk in here, raid the place.
Nomi, really thinking he's invincible, but Muradin, he can always jump out, so at least that's one thing he's got going for him. But that's yeah, that's a lot of seeds that went to We're Not Prepared, and they're gonna go and grow their Terra now. Let's see who's gonna go in there. Looks like Tesla might be running up there. No, not just yet.
If Tesla gonna hold mid for a sec, that lane was pushed a bit. Gonna grab the XP from the minions and clear it up so his towers don't lose too much ammo. Terra is ready for We Are Not Prepared, but they're grabbing mercenaries, leaving it as late as they can. It will probably be Darker taking it due to the fact that he's not really being healed that often. He did just get healed, so I might be wrong. Arthas going very ham here, just running straight into Sokke. And I like what Black Scorp's doing here. He's being very careful to not get meleeed by Sokke, so that Sokke can't really get that much mana back. And now, however, they're trying to 1v1, and as I pointed out, Sokke actually losing a bit of that 1v1, and he's gone more with the Chain Lightning here.
Well, he is a level back, so still waiting for that level 7 talent, which should be coming in now. So we'll check that out, and battle it's momentum. Battle Momentum.
Yeah, just Battle Momentum combined with Wind Fury is a fantastic thing. Does so much.
But how does mana issues come into play there?
Because you're spamming it. Spam Wind Fury whenever it's up, and you throw your wolf at people whenever you can. And in this case, he's going to be lightninging people first, then battle momentum, then Wind Fury, and the combination of that and battle momentum will give him mana and mana and cooldown reduction as he goes. I like the build. It's not something I've seen before, but it is cool. Right now, though, he's having to use these abilities on Darker to try and help defend this bottom lane.
Yeah, the tower's already out of ammo. One of the walls has gone down, so Darker not doing the usual rotation, but instead sticking to one lane and letting the other heroes take dish out some damage on the other lanes. And he will get rid of that wall and both of the towers, so that's a lot of XP going the way of We're Not Prepared.
I think Sokke's been hit by every single curse at this point. He's like, hang on. Nope, didn't get hit by that one, so he managed to still kill the last one. But now, Darker actually going on to Hasselhobbs here, but realizes he can't take it alone. We'll back up a bit here, play it a bit safer. In the meantime, the party top lane doing lots of damage here. Falcon a bit too far forward, is actually taking aggro here, but with the minions coming in, he will be able to lay waste to this top four. Black Scorp though going
Oh, Hysterica's in trouble. Polymorph goes down on Black Scorp, but nice heal. Haruki being on top of things, but still that Ford is in trouble and looks like Black Scorp. Falcon and Polydor can take it out. Haruki's the only one here right now. Yep, that Ford does go down. And that's the first Ford kill going the way of We're Not Prepared.
Yeah, We Are Not Prepared. Actually doing a great job here. They've, like you said, they've already taken the first Ford. They've completely exposed the bottom lane Ford as well. So that will probably be their next target. And they're doing a fantastic job here. They are completely even in kills because no one has died yet. We are still waiting on that first blood. Both teams right now going for their mercenaries to just get some pushing done. We're going to see Wellmet get theirs first, but We Are Not Prepared. Very much prepared, are not far behind.
Yep, also going for their mercs and switching lanes now. Really surprised that we haven't seen a kill here. Usually you see the first kill happening in the first night, but it's not happened so far. But now Black Scorp's going deep into enemy lines, but he has an entire team behind him. And Thrall also joining the fray. Right now only Murky, only Brightwing not in the game. But she's gonna join here pretty soon. And, ooh, the Rain has come in. Darker out of position, polymorphed, and goes down with the final blow. Nomi is back in the fight, trying to find an angle here on Falcon. Tries to get in the back there, but looks like We're Not Prepared. They're going for the retreat. Killer Chino caught out and taking a lot of damage, but Phase Shift comes in and he gets out, but still goes down here. Black Scorp, Falcon, and Polydor, they're on the run, and looks like they can get away. But this opens up the possibility here for Wellmet to grab a lot of seats and finally go for their own Garden Terror.
Yep, that was a great fight by Wellmet there. Tranquility did such a great job of healing up the members of We Are Not Prepared, but it's just not enough in this scenario. And now we're seeing Sokke go onto Black Scorp here. In comes Brightwing to assist him. Black Scorp on the run.
They're looking for the body block.
Yep, sending it up. There's the route. Gonna be able to lock him down, but in comes Falcon and Polator, and we're gonna see Haruke actually almost go down here, but able to blink heal out onto Hasselhobbs. All five members of both teams are here and ready to fight, but we're seeing Wellmet play a bit more safe here. They already have a Plant Terror ready. Doesn't look like they want to risk losing people while they have that advantage while raiding the other Shambler here.
Yeah, makes total sense. They're trying to find an angle here. Hasselhobbs and Haruki are waiting down there, and Killer Chino, he's getting ganked upon, but can that be it? Nope. Not when the entire team is still there.
Yep,
so, Garden Terror should be grown here. Yep, it's already out. Zoc is in there. And trying to find an engagement angle here on the mid lane.
Yeah, this is what WorldMet nice likes knockout. To do a lot more than some other teams. They, well, most teams seem to like they're split pushing a lot more to Terra. And I agree with the big group up in this situation, but WorldMet seems to be a lot more of a fan of the big group push with the Terra. Look for team kills while they can due to the stuns on they get from Muradin, and just push with the Terra, get the maximum amount of damage down they can, rather than split pushing and just pushing different lanes.
I like the split pushing, to be honest. You can't really engage as long as both teams have the Terra. If you're the only team with the Terra, sure, go for it. You really need that. But if both teams have them, don't really try that. It's just running back and forth, and that little dance around the Garden Terrace doesn't really do all that much.
Indeed. So right now, WorldMet, they're not actually getting that much done because both teams are grouped up. And like I said, this is what happens with the group up. You get the Dance of Death, in comes the Bulb, but we're going to see the engagement here. Domi popping his avatar now, is going on to Darker, and Black Scorp now is the one who's getting caught out. He pops his ult and is going to heal up here. The curse, it's three people, so much cursing happening right now. But they're all pretty much full health back to that Tranquility, but the knockback from Reyna is able to save Nomi as he backs out. And they, once again, weren't able to get the fort. They got it down to half health, but once again, no one died. We're still only two kills into this game, and those are on a Anubarak.
It's pretty insane. 10 minutes into the game, still only two kills. Really passive game, but still lots of action going on. It's weird. It's weird like that. But still, they're going for both Merc camps here. And Falcon helping out Black's corpse, so Bruiser Camp is also going to the way of we're not prepared. And yep, they're looking for that final Siege Camp down here.
Yeah, Nomi is still doing 1k damage per Q onto buildings, by the way. And we can see what kind of damage that's doing by looking at the middle lane fort. He's been harassing that for quite a while.
And so, siege damage, let's have a look here. Where is Muradin? 15,000, okay, not too shabby, but still one of the lesser heroes compared to Rainer with his 35. And Thrall also with the 35. Oh, there was a kill, damn it!
Yep, that was Sokke attempting to go in there with the Rainer, but Rainer was caught out and the Sunder was not able to save him. So Sokke is actually down his ult now. Which apparently doesn't work on the cooldown tab, so that's unfortunate. It does work if you click on him, though.
Alright, and they have to stop the Bruisers in the top lane now. Meanwhile, we're not prepared yet. They also need to react to that mid lane push by the Bruisers. And at the same time, going on to the fort in the bot lane, and they should be able to get the kill here. Along with those stolen Bruisers, they might be able to even do some damage here on the walls in the keep.
Quite possibly, but they're going to be using this opportunity instead to get seeds. Both teams just making the mad dash for seeds right now. The Terra is already available, but we are not prepared. But WorldMet definitely going to get one of their own once they deal with this Shambler here. They'll be able to take that down quite quickly. Pretty much definitely before we are not prepared to get there, and we are not prepared to realize this, and are instead going to be using this opportunity to push with their Bruisers and Siege Giants to get the damage to try and take down some damage on the walls, towers, gates, and maybe even the keep. And then it will get their Terra, and we can see WorldMet reacting to this, all of them instantly just being back to base to try and defend this. Sokke grabbing the Terra to help with the defense, but we are not prepared. Already backing out, they are playing safe. They are just going to back up, grab their Terra, and get ready to push themselves. Probably going to use the Terra to take down those Siege Giants in the top lane.
Yeah, they have a pretty solid half a level lead right now. And they just need to do a little bit in these team fights, which I think they can. But ooh, Falcon is in trouble. There comes the Polymorph, and he gets behind the wall. But still, that wall's no real opponent right there. Goes down in just a jiffy. And Falcon still caught out there. And there we go. She goes down. Just one blow, it looked like.
Yeah, that was a lot of damage in one go there. Hiruke blinking out from the damage he was taking from Killachino there. In comes Darker, though, and he's going straight onto Nomi, but Sokke bringing in the body block, able to keep Nomi alive. And now that bot fort will go down. And there's the re-engage onto Black Scorp and Prolator. Prolator much squishier, will go down very quickly. Nomi continuing to go ham here. His ult is down. He's very low on mana. So they're just going to turn this onto the plant terror here. Soke, 49 seconds left of his duration and is at a lot lower health. But that damage coming out from Well Met is enough to take him down. Good lord.
Yeah, really, really strong push here down the bot lane. And it looks like they still stick around. But now Hammer is back, and I think with Hammer back, once she joins the fight, they will probably back off. That long range and attack, it's gonna help out quite a bit here. Killuccino, he's quite low on mana.
Such a nice combo when it comes to just being annoying.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. Just sticking around. And I think like having Hammer on the team on this map does help out quite a bit for defense purposes. And yeah, just really, really solid composition to have her in there.
I would agree. Right now, going to see Well Met taking their own mercenaries, whereas we are not prepared. Preparing for a gank, but they are spotted, unfortunately. They're trying to get onto Soke and Hasselobs, though, but both of them just dashing out there. Soke using the speed boost from Wind Fury to dash out the way of that route, and Hasselobs was just out of range of it anyway. And Soke just being very annoying, throwing in his long range abilities, getting as much down as possible. But there's the Sunder onto Falcon, but Falcon's not the engage here. It's going to be Darker who is taking the damage. The Mafurian heal, though, is not going to be enough. Even with the healing totem, everyone's going down here. Falcon is now going to be engaged upon. Stun takes him out. Root coming in from Malfurion, trying to keep the rest of the team alive. But Malfurion is the one who's going to get rooted. Nice root there from Blackscorp. Oh. Trying to save his team. Down goes Malfurion. Blackscorp pops Stone Skin and is able to keep himself alive. But that is a 4-0 for Well Met, and they are just going to destroy everything right now.
They're just wrecking these team fights, to be honest. And that's exactly what I thought when I looked at their composition. I mean, it's just really, really solid. Not as squishy as I think, just because you have that Rainer. And Thrall, if you play him carefully, does look to be...
Rainer has a passive heal, Thrall has passive heal. The only one who doesn't have passive heal is Vala, and that's what Brightwing has been concentrating on. She took the stone skip, she took the protective shield instead of the envenom just to protect Vala and keep her alive.
Alright. So they're gearing up to take a lot more seats. Plantera's already grown. Looks like Rainer might jump in there.
They're all backing up, actually. They're all grabbing health and mana, and I think they plan on ending here. Like they all be down. They don't want to get caught out. So they're now moving to the top lane to possibly grab mercenaries. Definitely take down that fort. Thrall taking the Terra. I'm going to be joining his team, or at least going through this mid lane. And I think Well Met intend to end here.
Interesting. Looks like they're gearing up for the seats again and the Shambler. Well, not gonna end it just now.
Well, they're definitely gonna be able to take the Shambler. They're definitely gonna be able to take down top fort.
And we are seeing, that's for sure.
We are not prepared. Finally grabbing their own Terra as well. That will help them defend here. But it's not going to save this top fort. That will 100% go down straight away. And before the Terra even gets there, like Terra gets in range and fort is already down. And we're just going to see Well Met back out here. They don't need to fight. They have the advantage here. They've taken down more forts. They've taken down a keep. So this mid lane is just going to keep pushing. And Well Met actually going to move down to this bot lane to clear the wave. Due to the fact that it's a 5v5, they can win the team fight, but they don't see the reason to risk it yet.
Yeah, they don't really want that level 20 before they engage in the next team fight, which makes a lot of sense. So just clearing the waves and going for the team fight afterwards. They have level 20 now, so let's check out their talents. We have Bolt of Storm on Rainer, on Thrall, and on Vela. Then the Unstoppable Force, so the better ultimate for Muradin, and Storm Shield for Brightwing.
Yep, and Killuccino getting locked down straight away, is still polymorphed and goes down before he can even use his phase shift. Easy pickup there for Well Met, and they now have a man advantage. Both teams have their Terra. Soke just making the most of his Terra, only has 18 seconds left. Nobi already onto Falcon, he's going to get polymorphed though. And Falcon getting so much support here, able to stay alive. But this keep will go down. Soke is about to pop out in about 5 seconds. But he's already done what he needs to do. He's made sure that We Are Not Prepared have wasted most of their Terra and got a keep and cleared all of the waves and got the top lane fort.
Yeah, that's two keeps down right now. and they only have a single keep left, and now it's really, really dangerous for them to even leave their own base. They need to watch out. They need to watch out for those back doors, and looks like well met. They're just gonna rotate down, rotate up, and see what they can do here, hiding in the death bush.
And I would like to point out that I was completely wrong about Froll's talents. He did take Battle Momentum and he took Sundering, but for the last two talents, took Grace of Air, which means Wind Fury gives him more stacks of Frostwolf Resilience, which is more of a bruiser build, and he took Blood for Blood as one of his talents, which is nice considering the enemy team has two tanks, but still not what I expected.
Yep, they also have Stone Skin twice, and then Blood for Blood on Nubarak.
Yeah.
They're gearing up, looking to take this top fort down, or top keep down. One of the towers already gone, second tower still has a lot of ammo left. But we're not prepared, they need to gear up. They need to get a good concave going, maybe lure him back in there.
I think so. We're seeing Soke though, just staying at range, throwing in his chain lightning, and because that hits the two extra targets, it's still getting quite a bit of harass down. He's still getting his Frostwolf stack, so he's just getting sustained here. The wolf does miss though, and they're actually doing tiny amounts of damage to this fort, to this keep as well. They have giants here, they can keep this up for quite a while. Anubarak really needs to get the engagement if we are not prepared. Wants to have any chance of really getting out of this, but Nomi is gonna get the engage instead. Onto Falcon, there's the Reign of Vengeance, and Nubarak gets taken out so quickly. And well met, not even gonna continue engaging here, they just move back. And he's gonna take down the keep and poke people from as far again. Now they're moving in onto Killachino because he was out of position. He goes down and Yori uses space shift. Down goes Malfurion. Falcon, the only one left alive. There's giants in the mid lane. There's giants in the
lane. This should be game. There's catapults, there's giants, and there's about a four-man team versus a single Sergeant Hammer. That's not gonna work. Well met is gonna go 1-0 versus We're Not Prepared.
Yeah, very well played by Well Met. Doing a great job, and they will be moving on to the semi-finals, I believe. Yes, onto the...
Nope, that's best of three, so we're still in the first
game. Oh yeah, best of three. Oh yeah. Ooh.
Yeah.
I'm interested because We're Not Prepared did play very well in the early game there.
For sure.
Maybe on
for
a slightly shorter map, because that is the longest map when it comes to game lengths. So
well, we'll have to see. Sky Temple, I think, is a pretty big contender as well.
Oh, is that what's next?
let's see. Nope, it's actually Black Hearts Bay.
Hey,
but still, Sky Temple is one of those maps that's also, I think it's going to turn out as one of the longer maps eventually.
Yeah, all right. I would agree.
Black Hearts Babe is the next map. You're right. Okay, so we'll have to see if we have a draft link for that already prepared. Looks like we have one.
Excellent.
So I'll send that the way of the players.
Okay, did you send it the way of the me?
The way of you, sure.
The way of the Tetcher.
Should we be casting in colorblind mode? As far as I know, colorblind mode is still not finished, so you'll have part of the text being in orange and blue and parts are not. So I don't think it really makes sense until they really finish up colorblind mode and polish it a little bit. But I guess
once
looks like our admins are going to talk about
ready,
it.
I 100% agree that colorblind mode should be the standard. It's a tiny bit of different colorization for some people that means that other people, that means a whole nother set of people can watch the game properly.
But I think it's never really gotten established in StarCraft 2, has it? Like, no one uses colorblind mode.
No, and that annoys me very much so.
It's true. It's true. I mean, it's a simple fix to get a lot of people more interested in the game. To actually see what's going
on. It's just letting them watch without discomfort. No, not discomfort, maybe just watch better,
well, it's just extra info. Well, extra. Yeah. Vital info, let's say.
Yeah. All right, okay. I have joined the lobby. Well. And I will click the draft link.
All right, let's join that lobby. As I said, the next map is played out on Black Hearts Bay.
Oh, I just closed the wrong draft link. Oops. Just close this one instead of last one. All right, they haven't readied up yet, so I'm going to run for a quick bio break. And in the meantime, is the bracket still going? Has anyone basically managed to finish two games yet? No, they have not, unfortunate.
I don't think anyone has.
Not on my bracket.
We can ask for updates in the chat. Let me just
I will
do
be
that.
Right back quickly while you do that.
Yeah. Alright, let me just ask for a couple scores. And I think, did I capture a replay? I think I did. This was last map, was it? Yeah, that was the last map. I captured one for this map? I think I did, yeah. Here we go. Just a single fight though, I really need to work on that. But let's see, let's have a look here. So, we'll seek out the right time. Let's do it. Okay, I think... Yeah, this there shouldn't be too many kills, but just the way that we're not prepared, how they're going into this. I think this was actually the fight where they, where we saw the first two kills, but... See, Nomi was always a little overeager, but it worked out quite fine for him. And Darker, this is actually kind of a ballsy move, but he's moving right onto Hysterica with his deep tunnel. Still, it's really, 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 really ballsy to do this. And I think it's going to end up hurting him right now. Yeah, he gets completely out of position. This is why zoning is so incredibly important. And this is the reason why Nomi can pull this off, because he can still jump out of this if he wants to. And he's doing just that. But Anubarak, once his deep tunnel is down and he doesn't have rewind, and I think, was rewind removed for Anubarak? I think so.
Hello there.
Hey, do you know if rewind was removed for Anubarak?
Yes.
Yeah, so he can't do that double deep tunnel anymore.
Tunnel in, knock up, tunnel out.
Peace. Exactly. But Nomi can still do this or Muradin rather, can still do this really hats on. I'm going to go in there, do a little bit of damage, and jump back out. And this is exactly what he did here with the Avatar form. And that's how they got their first kill, which was the first blood in the game. So really good zoning for Wellmet, and I think they carried that through through the entirety of the game. Killuccino also getting caught out here with a nice stun, and I think, yep, he had Envenom on him to take him out. And Nomi even jumping out of there and not going down. So really, really nice teamfights for Wellmet all the way through.
Yep, draft has started, by the way.
Okay, so let's have a look at how
we're seeing a very familiar set of picks and bans here so far.
All right.
So, we are not prepared to get the first ban. They started with banning Stitches, and Wellmet, once again, coming in with the Zeratul ban. First pick is Brightwing. Like I said, very familiar set of picks and bans here.
Yeah, does look really similar. I like that they're able to grab Brightwing again in the first pick. We'll have to see how...
Well, no, it was a...
Oh, true.
It's the same picks, it's just reversed. Yep.
We're not prepared. I just messed up looking at the draft. Okay, so Wellmet, they'll have to go with Uther this time. Or I could also go for Malfurion, but to be honest, I didn't see Malfurion work out that well in the last game.
Yeah, I would agree. Probably an Uther would make a lot more sense. Or, for all we know, they could just bring in Rhaegar and go full Bloodlust. Because why the hell not?
Vala is the first pick.
Yeah, I want your opinion on this. Someone actually brought up a really good point in the chat that English is a horrible language. Like, I know you are someone who's had to learn and speak English at a very convincing level from another country. English is one of the languages the most exceptions and rules, and where there are other languages that are much better when it comes to learning. What is your opinion on that?
Well, I think it's an easy language to pick up, but hard to master. It's the Blizzard philosophy for languages. yeah, I mean, you're right. There are a lot of exceptions and rules. Well, not really rules, but exceptions. But they don't really screw you as much as...
I mean, for C, which was a rule for like many years until someone pointed out it was wrong.
Okay. And then you have the Latin languages and German, and basically any Latin-based language has a lot of grammar and a lot of rules that are... just make it easier to learn. Well, harder to learn, but
French is
once you got it going, you can learn. Well, if you know a little bit of French, you can go into Spanish and Italian and. German kind of stands on its own.
It's such a weird thing that you have, especially in French, words have genders. That's confusing to me. That makes very little sense. It makes it a lot harder to learn.
Hmm. Okay, the next pick was Muradin here. And
Yep.
I think some people are asking for a cast of the Arthas game. I think that's going on the Russian channel somewhere. I saw the link earlier, but to be honest, I have no idea. Maybe the admins can send the way.
I don't know what the link is, but yeah, that's Refuse versus Arthas, isn't it, on the Russian channel?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but did you get any updates for the other games, by the way? Or are they all currently happening?
I don't think we got any.
Let me check who's on my friends list. Beatar Bakers are in-game on Sky Temple for 17 minutes, so they are in... Well, one Sky Temple? Oh, no, wait, that's his display message. It doesn't say the map. It just says best of one Sky Temple for the win. as his message. But Beatar Bakers are in-game for 17 minutes. So that'll be game two, I'm assuming, seeing as Garden of Terror is long. Who else? Mad Corps. No, wait, Mad Corps went out. Who did they go out to? They went out to Aperient is Lots. They are in game for... Oh, they're in lobby, so I'm assuming they're game one out, but I'm not sure what the score is.
Okay, yeah, so no updates yet. As soon as we have updates on the other matches, we'll get into them. But we do have an update in the draft. Arthas and Tassel are picked up for We're Not Prepared. I don't know. Is Zagara still a valid option right now? Because I like Zagara on Blackheart's Bay.
We see her a lot in solo queue kind of thing, but otherwise not really very often, considering she still has one of the best ults in the game, and actually double Hunter Killer is huge damage, and she gives vision. I'm really surprised we don't see more, but Thrall making a second return here for Well Met.
Okay.
It's time for round two. Let's see him see if he can keep this up.
For sure. Kind of surprised that We're Not Prepared didn't go for Thrall after they saw him wreck through the lines last game.
Yeah. Like we've said, he is new. He's just such... If you are not comfortable with him yet, seeing as how relatively new he is, it's a very risky pick.
Yeah, it's only been, what, like 4 days?
Yeah, but on the bright side, people don't know how to play against him either.
Yeah, that's good. So if you just duked out your games... All the games in Thrall, with Thrall, then you're good to go.
Indeed. So, right now...
I like Super Cardi. Can we just settle down on Klingon as the main shoutcast language?
I would agree with... I'd learn that.
You can actually Google Translate to Klingon.
Yeah, it would be good. It would make it much more exclusive. You could only get into East. It would make every game level. Like, currently, there's a huge thing about entry level when it comes to esports. Like, True. You can come in and just understand the game just by casting it, which I'd like to think we do here well enough. We explain things best we can. But some other games might not. Like, Smite's the best one for it at the moment because they have a noob stream, which is kind of cool.
Dota 2 also has that, at least for the international.
This is true. So it's nice and it's very new player friendly. But that would all be completely removed if it was like, okay, so what do I have to know to get into this? Well, you have to know what lanes are. You have to know how many players are per team. Oh, yeah, and you have to learn Klingon.
All right. I don't think that's really the Blizzard philosophy, but no. Don't care.
Beatar Bakers won against Mad Corps.
Oh, nice.
Yay!
Just as you said. As you expected. interesting draft, though. We're Not Prepared. Hammer and Illidan.
Oh, wow.
Meanwhile, Well Met going for Uther and Nazibo as their final picks. Kind of surprised that they picked Uther as their second to last, but maybe they didn't want to be locked out by We're Not Prepared.
We're Not Prepared already had their support, so...
Yeah, but they could have gone for Uther and Brightwing. That's doesn't make true. Too much sense, but...
I've won with double support before on Hero League, but that was just pure luck, and the guy had... The only other option the guy was giving us... We already had, like, three assassins, and the only other option the guy gave us was Illidan. So I was like, just take another support, and we'll just heal our assassins until they die. And it worked, so... But that was pure luck, because Hero League solo queue is horrible. But yeah, Illidan is interesting. You're definitely going to be able to get very much up in the face of Nazibo. But considering there's Uther and there's Uther, there is Thrall, and there is Muradin on the other team, I'm really not sure about the Illidan pick. But I guess it's mostly I'm going to be all up in your face while Hammer shoots you from way back over there.
Okay, we're gonna have a little bit of a break here. Well, Matt needs some rest before they get into their next game.
Yeah. People are so, currently talking about low tiers and high tiers. What is your opinion on that?
Well, on tiers in general, I think they exist.
currently people are saying that Diablo is the lowest tier.
I think Murky is still the lowest tier.
Murky can still be played reasonably well due to the fact that you can get the huge burst combo, and combined with Abathur is basically unkillable.
Yeah, but only in pub games. That's never going to work.
I've seen it done in a pro game, but
okay, really?
In draft, you counterpick it. So you have to leave Murky till last, in which case you're revealing everything else. So it's a bit...
Otherwise, you're just going to go for Zeratul or something?
Yeah. Nova's also been brought up. Very bad now, which I really wish solo queue hit people would get. Nova has been nerfed. Please stop picking her. She is not good enough to really be ranked at the moment.
I don't really get the reasoning, to be honest. Why did they nerf her again? I think she was in a good spot.
They actually kind of buffed her auto attacks kind of thing, but she was still too heavily picked. I think they're trying to dissuade people from picking her at the moment because she is picked more than almost any other assassin in solo queue.
Maybe she's getting a huge revamp soon.
Maybe.
And they want to kind of get her on the down low for now. What about Diablo? I think now with Resurgence gone, he's broken?
Yeah, he never had Resurgence to begin with. So he's not in terms of being broken as in OP. He's physically broken. His Q now pushes people in a random direction, and it pushes half the distance it used to.
Why?
Because it broke.
Just the bug.
Yeah.
Okay.
So he is broken. He is bugged in a way. So he is currently the worst hero because he's broken in a bad way, as opposed to Tigers, who's broken in a good way.
Because I think you could make him work if all of his skills actually work the way they should.
I personally Diablo pre patch was one of my favorite heroes. He's still one of my favorite heroes post patch, except for the Q thing. It's destroyed him basically in terms of usability. But before that, people are saying ETC and Diablo are the lowest tiers in terms of warriors, which is why they're never picked. But running them together is actually a very, very viable comp in terms of pro games and in terms of solo queue, because you can mosh pit into Lightning Breath and basically kill everything.
What about his global heroic?
It's nice, but it's dodge.
I like it in solo queue. I've been stomped by it a few times because the moment you realize it, it's usually already too late.
Well, most of the times in a fight, you should really be standing still anyway. You should be microing to move to make sure you're as little target as possible for skill shots, etc. So I personally am not a fan of it. Lightning Breath, on the other hand, is reliable, and most importantly, it's uninterruptible.
Yeah.
It's one of the best ultimates in the game, in my opinion, but I am a huge Diablo fanboy. he is my boy.
And I played in a couple games. I think I liked him. Yeah. I like the mechanic with the soul stones and everything.
Yeah. Chen's very, very, very risky pick now. He used to be the best, but that 1 second to activate his ult now has completely removed him from popular play at the moment, which is why my suggestion to the community is play him on maps where there's golems and run barrel so you can knock people out of golem areas.
Ah, that's cool.
Steal the golems. Yeah,
I think the keg or the barrel is a really nice heroic, and it should be used more. But the other one was just so overpowered, so incredibly overpowered.
Not anymore, though.
Yeah, not anymore.
You have to activate it first now before you go into a fight, and it will still give you a second health bar kind of thing.
It's cool, but it's not that really. Well, you can't. Don't go for Shen. You can't kill him anyways. It's not that kind of deal.
I read that in the chat. Okay.
All right, we're still waiting on two players to ready up, and once that's all set, we can go.
Yep, and then we can get into the game as soon as possible. There we go. Respond with kindness. All right, so 9 out of 10 readied up. Get into the game soon. And seeing the last game and seeing well-met play on this map before, I'm currently leaning towards well-met.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Especially with this lineup. I think We're Not Prepared has a little bit of a wonky lineup, which might not work out in their way. If they get an early lead, I think they could pull it off, but I don't know. Don't ever get behind with that composition.
Yeah, and I'm typing this guy in the chat right now, but this guy says Anubarak is the lowest warrior. I would agree if he wasn't such an incredible counter to Nazibo.
Yeah. Nazibo, this disrupt is amazing. He's really cool for just contesting map objectives as well.
Indeed. And yes, rip Panda Pals. We will miss you. We hope you're used maybe a bit more. But
they're probably
going to
come back and play.
Game number two, it will be on Black Hearts Bay. Currently, Wellmet is 1-0 up. Ken, we are not prepared to bring it back.
All right. We'll have to find out. We've loaded into the game. Heroes are joining. And on the left side, as the blue team here on Black Hearts Bay, we have once again Wellmet. They're 1-0 up, and Zaka is again playing Thrall. We have Nomi on Muradin, Hiruki is playing Nazibo, Hysterica is playing Vala, and Hiruki is playing Uther.
And on the right-hand side, in the red trunks, it is We Are Not Prepared, and it is T-Darka playing the Arthas. It is Killachino once again on the Tassadar. Black Scorp is on the Illidan Falcon, returning to his Sergeant Hammer, and Polator is taking the Brightwing.
Yep, indeed. And we have a little bit of a split going on. The entirety of Wellmet is going for that watchtower, but only T-Darka is there for We're Not Prepared, so he needs to watch out. It's a little bit of Chain Lightning, but nothing else happening. So that's solid control going to Wellmet for the top half of the map. But bottom half is in solid control here for We're Not Prepared.
Yep, We Are Not Prepared. Choosing to take control of the bottom half of the map is quite interesting, but it does mean they're going to get huge control here for when the coins come up, and they're actually stopping Hasuobs getting too much lane push down.
And up here, Thrall, still taking the top lane, still putting up some decent counter pressure here to Arthas. And he's just sticking around and waltzing back and forth between top and mid lane, trying to help out with the chests here, but looks like Nomi grabbed all 5 coins.
Yep, Nomi. And with it being Nomi with the coins, he's going to be able to stay pretty safe on his own. And that's what we're seeing here. His team leaving him alone for a bit while he clears the wave so that they can try and get some more coins of their own. Hysterica moving into the bot lane through the lane so as not to get caught out here, so can join up with Hasuobs here, see if they can possibly get a kill and to stop the party lane that's going on. Black Scorp was able to grab the 5 coins from the bot lane and has already turned them in.
That's nice. Sometimes we see these players going for just too many coins carrying on one hero, and it's incredibly dangerous. So I like when he actually gets the time, turns it in, and plays it safe. Ruki is still waiting here on Uther, trying to get a jump on Polydor, but I don't think that's going to happen. He's playing pretty safe here.
Yep, and it is Brightwing. Speed boosts, passive heals. Very hard to kill a Brightwing at this early stage in the game. Nomi, still once again, just completely chilling here. He can do whatever he likes, and his passive health regen is still pretty nice. Even with the fix of the bug, he's still pretty tanky, and he's getting his stacks off quite nicely. He's already, let's have a look here. He's already managed to stack up he's already stacked up 4 hits on his Perfect Storm and is still doing major damage to that bottom tower.
Yep, let's check out the builds again. Rolling Thunder and Ride the Lightning again for Thrall. And what else do we have here? Of course, Bribe on Brightwing, and Arthas going with Envenom. Healing Ward taken here by Tassadar. And Shadow Shield alongside Immolation for Illidan. And there's the turn-in finally happening here for Wellmet.
Yep, Immolation is pretty cool, is very, very cool. It's a lot of extra damage on that ability. And I'd like to point out how cool it is that we have 3 people on the side of Wellmet who have identical icons for the talents they chose. They're all focusing on that Q ability, except for Valor, which is a W.
Yep. And we have double the hammers.
Yeah, double hammers. Get Ufa in. If they had Ufa on their team, then it would be the Hammer Bros. Throw Falstad in. Is there a fifth hammer?
Well, Sergeant Hammer, but that's a totally different one.
Close enough, there's your team.
Bruiser camp has been taken here for We're Not Prepared, and they're making the strong fight happen here in the mid lane, but I think that Fort is still... No! Wow! So just one more hit.
He's trying to chain lightning it. Sokka is just sitting there. He's trying to get
Chain
Lightning.
One more hit. One more hit. Oh, oh, nice shield.
Like there
oh,
we go.
There goes the final blow.
Radiance from Huroke is what takes it down in the end.
Yep, but they need to react to these bruisers, otherwise their Ford is in trouble as well, but Historica gets in there, Haruki helps out, and even Zocke moving in, sending out a Chain Lightning to clear off those bruisers. Polydor might be able to help, but nope, I don't think they're gonna really go for it. Instead, going for the steal here on the Watchtower, and that's the next barrage coming into the mid lane. Unfortunately, I don't think that We're Not Prepared got some damage done here beforehand, so it's not gonna take out the Ford.
Yep, won't take out the fort. Still going to get some decent damage down, like you said. And right now, both teams fairly even. They're going to hit level 9 almost identical times. Yeah, split second apart. Mule, though, is a very, very interesting pick here by Nazibo, especially on this map.
Interesting. Could drag this out. Ooh, Zocca's in trouble. He's taking a lot of damage. Darkrai's on top of him. Black Scorp jumps behind him and takes him out. Oh, Nomi also taking a lot of damage. There comes the body block out of Black Scorp, but looks like he can jump away. Hiruke trying to follow him, heal him back up. And Vala is taken out. Ooh, nice little early team fight here for We're Not Prepared. And there comes the final blow on the fort. So that's one for one for the forts.
Indeed. And what we saw there was we saw Sokka try to come in with Froll there to do some damage, but he got rooted by Arthas, meaning that he could not complete the animation on his last Wind Fury, which he needs to do to continue auto-attacking. So he was stuck there, stuck in the animation that he couldn't complete because he couldn't move forward, meaning all damage he had was removed, and then Brightwing just polymorphed him and Illidan was able to chase him down.
Okay, we have the boss being taken. And well, Matt knows about this, but instead they're just using the time to turn in. They knew, okay, we couldn't contest this, not with a player down, not without our level 10 talents. Now all of the heroics are up, so let's check them out. We have Sundering on Thrall, Ravenous Spirit taking Manazibo, Divine Storm for Uther, Reign of Vengeance for Vala, and the Avatar going the way of Muradin. On the other hand, Metamorphosis for Illidan, Archon for Tassadar, Army of the Dead on Arthas, Emerald Wind for Brightwing, and Napalm Strike being taken here by Sergeant Hammer.
Nice to finally see an Emerald Wind being taken, and I really thought the Proletor was actually going to try and just dash in there and use Emerald Wind to steal that easy camp, but it is an easy camp. Not really too worth there. But instead going to move in, did get a Polymorph off, and is now going to move in and start helping his team take down this bottom four, and that will put We Are Not Prepared slightly ahead, but I'd point out they missed a coin just up there, just while we're going.
Yep, they will get that fort, and ooh, looks like Uther and Nomi, they're gearing up to possibly go for a takedown. Oh, nice Divine Storm, Polydor taking a lot of damage, and a good body block out of Nomi, they take Polydor down, and Black Corp also caught out of position, but he goes for his ultimate, stays alive, there comes another. Ooh, nice stun, but Black Corp does get away. So, only one kill for Well-Met. But still, a nice move, and now they can go for the bruisers and possibly put on some more pressure in this bottom lane.
The last minute Metamorphosis out of Illidan there to keep himself alive. Very well played, but like you said, well met. Taking a good amount of control here, grabbing those bottom bruisers, and they're still turning in coins as they go. There's another turn in from Nomi, and that will do a lot of damage to this top lane, but top lane has taken no preliminary damage, so this will no way kill the fort.
Yeah, still, I like this. I like this when they actually have four players just applying the pressure and just one player turning in. Because otherwise you get these situations where you're just kind of scared to turn in. But if you do it that way, you can always turn in safely because the other team is preoccupied trying to defend that fort.
Yep, and we saw both teams. Bit of a scuffle down at this bot, down at the bot fort. It doesn't actually die or even take any really any health damage or any significant health damage. Once again, well met. Taking control of the turn-in area to make sure Historica has an easy chance to turn in. while we see we are not prepared, they're going to be taking their own mercenaries. They have a lot of coins of their own, but they just can't seem to get to the turning point yet.
Yep, let's check those out. Currently 10 coins being carried by We're Not Prepared, so they need to watch out not to lose those.
Yep.
And that's a dangerous situation we talked about before. Ooh, two doubloons for free for Nomi!
I think they were trying to use them as bait there, but it did not work out, and they also saw the enemy coming, so they were like, oh, get out, but they forgot the coins. Very unfortunate for them, but now they're actually, I think, going to attempt to turn in here, due to the fact that World Met is so high on the map. Can someone please grab that coin? It's driving me insane.
Yeah, I'm so... like, it looks like a present up there. It does. And it truly is.
We left this for you.
It looks like the bruises will be taken here for Well Met now. And they've almost caught up in levels. Level 14 is ready and available now. So, I have to check out once they get to that level.
Yeah, we will see. There is the bruiser. They're grabbing it. Well, I thought he was going to leave that coin as well, but they actually did get it in the end. And now we're going to see Well Met using that Wind Fury to take down the top four. It was already weakened by the barrage, and we're actually going to see Well Met are going to lose their top four as well, thanks to the barrage. I really thought Battle was going to take that coin, but in the meantime, we're seeing a lot of Well Met be. In fact, all of them are being here due to the fact that, once again, we are not prepared, doing what they usually do, of just pushing another lane while Well Met's off doing something just to pull them all back and get some map control.
Yeah, really good idea here. Good decision making. Just drawing them all out and then retreating before they actually get there, making it not really worth their time, because they could have gone for counter-aggression in that time. So I like this. I like this play out of Winner Prepared. A couple of free coins here. Let's see. Are we going to see a fight here? Nope. Chests are coming up and it looks like there will be a split here. Illidan and Sergeant Ham are going to take the top chest, and bottom chest goes to Well Met.
Yep, Well Met taking control, and they're going to be the ones who are going to get to turn in due to having a bit more control, but we are not prepared. Looking for their opportunity, and they are going to force them back thanks to the combination of Storms and the Frozen Waste from Arthas.
And that's why you love Storms. You just storm next to Blackbeard. And have all Blackheart and storm in the shadows there and in the fog.
Yeah, storm into the fog of war and you can just harass them to death. It's why I enjoyed playing Asmodan's level 10. It was just, I'm gonna harass you forever and stop you doing anything. Nomi though has engaged here, popped his avatar and is going off the protocol. There's the Sunder, so much damage. Hasselhobbs is in the back here doing all the damage. Blackscorp has turned around to get him. Hysterica is taking a lot of damage as well here. Does have Volt up though. And is able to Volt
nice. Nice Volt. And look at that. So many coins being picked up here by Hiruke. Wow. That's almost the next barrage. And three kills. What a team fight for Well Met.
I think it is the next. No, it isn't. My bad. I miscounted. Well, Golem's respawned and he's actually glitched and turned sideways a bit because the coin is still there. Apparently coins bought even golems. Who knew? So there you go. Little factor for you. We are
okay, so leave that coin there and have the golem further back. Not bad.
Yeah. Even though you actually kind of want it further forward so you can get nearer to the vents so you can see.
Yeah, true.
So I don't know if you can make the coin spawn behind him. I don't know. It's the most useless piece of information you will ever hear.
I think some pro players would probably just abuse the heck out of it somehow.
If a pro can find a way to make the coins body blocking the golem useful, then all props to them. I will actively send them something. I will find them and I will send them something. Something.
Meanwhile, bruisers are in the bottom lane and wailing away here at the minions. But Well Met is reacting. Hasselhobbs is getting into position to react here. And we'll see another barrage coming their way. Meanwhile, the last one already hit the mid lane, took out one of the towers and the wall here. So this time it's going to be the keep that's going down.
Yeah, and they've also lost the fountain, so I don't think it will kill the keep because it had to take down two towers as well. I think it takes at least it takes over half a barrage to kill just a keep on its own.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think it's seven cannonballs.
Well, this is six. So
it's not gonna be quite enough, but it's gonna be close. Maybe just another chain lightning in there.
Let's see. One, two. Nope, exactly.
Oh, exactly six.
Exactly six to take down a key. The more you
thought
know.
It was seven for some reason, but yeah, six. Six is good.
Yeah, they had five. Actually, it might have been seven. I might have miscounted. But I don't know. Right now, well met taking their bruiser camp. And we're finally seeing we are not prepared, using this opportunity to get their turn in. And it's still not enough. They're only turning in half the amount of coins they need. And that was their best opportunity and their first opportunity, really, to get in there.
Yeah, but they lost so many coins on Arthas. That really hurt so badly. Meanwhile, the level 16 talents are up. Stoneskin being taken here by three heroes, Illidan, Arthas, and Sergeant Hammer as well. Then, of course, Critterize coming up on Brightwing. And Second Strike for Tassilar. So they really realize, okay, we need to win these team fights. We need to stay alive, have a little bit of better sustainability. So that's why you take the Stone Skin.
Indeed. And right now, we're once again going to see this strategy again. We are not prepared. Starting on that bottom keep and well met instantly, being back to base to defend this. But they are far too slow. That mule from Nazibo, nowhere near in time to deal with this. Nomi, though, continuing to chase. But there's the Emerald Wind. Great distance.
Finally coming into play here. Oh, a great wall here. Darker is completely caught out of that fight, but Black Scorps goes into Heroic. There comes Divine Storm, keeping Black Scorps at bay. But Hiroki, he goes down. Nazibo also taken out. But wow, they're really turning this around. Zarka, can he get away? Hysterica also quite low, but it looks like they can. Yep, they can.
Really, and run away. Really bad fight for well met there. They tried to get in. The Sunder did hit, but they were completely interrupted when it came to the Ravenous Spirit, so Nazibo wasn't able to get it down. The Divine Storm, Ufus did use his sprint, but by the time he got there and used it, Sunder had already gone down and completely split up the team. And now it's actually going to be a GG here, and we're going to see we are not prepared. Barely, because Sokei was just killing everyone there.
Yeah.
Hysterica. Take game number two, and we're going to a final game in this best of three series.
Wow, what a game. That was a single moment, like a single moment of negligence that lost in that game. We have to look at that last team fight again. That was nuts. Definitely. We'll have to take another look here.
All right, you load that up. I will make sure we get into a lobby.
Sure thing, sure thing. And then we'll give you guys some updates on the brackets. Actually, let's do the team fight analysis later on. And let's have a look at the brackets first.
Nothing else
and...
has happened in the bracket.
Really?
I've refreshed. Nothing else has happened. Still going.
So just beat our Bakers, advancing over Mad Corps.
Yeah.
And do we have any updates in the chat? I don't think we do.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think this is going to be our semi-final that we're going to cast then.
Yeah. Beat. I would like to put out, beat our Bakers now have... because they're already in the final. Anyone who to the quarterfinals, sorry, semi. Sorry, I'm an idiot.
Semi.
Anyone who gets to the semis, they have a 3 in 4 chance of getting into the HPL, because you can come in either team that gets into the finals. Both of them are going into HPL, and whichever team comes third is going into HPL. Just being here in the semifinals, you have such a good chance. 3 out of 4 is really good.
Yeah, it's not bad at all. And you have, even if you do get that fourth spot, you still get a round of 16 seed for the next one.
Yeah, this is true. So, yeah, do you want to load up that team fight? And I will...
All right, let's do it.
Lobby.
Okay, where's that last one? Over here. Let's do it. Actually, let's load up this one. Yeah.
Lobby's up, by the way.
Okay, I'll join soon.
Okay.
They're probably just setting up the
draft
links.
We're waiting for it, so no rush. And we obviously need draft links, etc.
Yeah. So let's have a look here. Okay. So this is probably... Yeah, this is the moment where Wellmet just Hearthstone back. And now they're on... Like, We're Not Prepared is on the retreat. But that save from Polydor just pushing them all back. And now I thought, okay, Hiroki runs in there. It gets a really good Divine Storm off. These look good initially. Okay, what happened here? I think I missed something right now.
Basically, the Sunder pushes Hammer completely out of the fight, so she's able to do huge damage from the back.
Yep, you're right. Let's have a look at this again.
Gonna run fire, by the way.
Yep, go ahead. Alright, so Sunder comes out and actually divides divides half of Winner Prepared, and the other half is just Illidan and Arphis. Arphis is caught out in the zombie wall with just Nomi in there, but he can still stand his ground. And usually you don't really like to divide your team, but since Zocker already took so much damage, he needs to get out of that fight. And here we have Illidan just jumping out, going into his heroic, and going back in there. Here comes the Divine Storm, just catching Darka and Black's Corp, and Killachino and Falcon, they can still do damage. Since Falcon is in the back, he just does so much splash damage on Hiruki, Nomi, and Hasu upstairs. I think this is really what killed him there. And Black's Corp does get out in the end. Meanwhile, everything just snowballs, and well met goes down the drain. So yeah, pretty amazing team fight here for Winner Prepared, and at a perfect spot too. I mean, if they would have been on the other side of the map and had it run over, I don't think they would have gotten the kill here on the core. But still, fighting there at the keep, wow, perfect, perfect timing for them. All right, so let me join that lobby and possibly get the draft link up already. We'll have a look here. Looks like draft has not started just yet. I'll send the way of the players.
I'm back.
Yeah, they're still waiting on most of the players. I just sent the draft link over.
Okay. Click. Nope, that is last time's draft link.
Is it?
The one I...
Oh, wait, I sent... I send one to Nomi. I'll send you one. Oh,
okay. Cheers.
There you go.
Thank you.
Okay. No word yet from either Well Met or We're Not Prepared.
Okay. Oh, they need to move us to the observer slots eventually. So, right now, having a look at the rest of the bracket, we still don't have results for them yet, as far as I'm aware. I've just refreshed just to make sure. Nope. So, who do you think's going to win the games that still have to play? We have one game left to play, this one, and we don't know the scores in the other games. Who do you think's going? Who do you think our semi-finalists are?
I think in the end, WellMet is going to make it. They just... That single mistake here, that single bad team fight just cost them the game. Overall, I think they were better in that match, just by a tiny margin, tiny, tiny. In the other maps, Ace Heaven probably going to advance. And to be honest, Team Refuse versus Arphis, I have no idea. I'd go for Refuse, but...
Both of these teams beat established tournament rosters, alternate. And Acer, both going down in the round of 16 there. So, both teams very deserving of their current spot. I'm very interested to see how it goes.
For sure, for sure. Okay. So I think at least Well Met is ready for the veto.
Yep.
By the way, the last map is going to be Cursed Hollow. And then afterwards we're going to the best of five for semifinals.
We've had three very very macro maps lately, very objective focused maps so far.
Macro maps.
I guess they
still have that SC2 lingo down.
I really do. Oh dear.
I've actually gotten into StarCraft 2 casting lately.
I know. I was
gotten
watching.
Back into it.
I was watching your WCS qualifier stuff. I did, however, leave you because, one, you ended, and right after you ended, the world record for the longest ever StarCraft 2 game.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw that. Yeah, the problem was some...
4 hours.
Yeah. But is that record now void since he has been disqualified?
No, he played the game all the way through. It would not be a record if he hadn't played, like... To be fair, his opponent could have gone and killed him at pretty much any point. So that's a bit off. Not off as in suspicious, off as in why didn't you do this, but yeah. having an observer view is amazing.
Poor puffy dude.
Yeah.
He had to cast the whole thing. Pewee, or whatever you pronounce it. Yeah.
His name is Robert Pugh, so it is Pewie.
Pewie. All right, we're getting started with the bans, and first ban is Zeratul, or Well Met. Let's see if it's going to be Stitches when we're not prepared.
Why are you doing that? We just got updated with scores.
Sweet.
1-1 currently with Ace versus Baron, and 1-0 to Team Refuse in, well, they are versus Arthas.
Okay.
So Baron 4, doing a great job, go 1-1 versus Ace.
Not bad.
Refuse versus Arthas.
For a team that we've both not heard about before, that's not bad at all. Oh, look at that. We have a different ban coming out of We're Not Prepared. It's Vala this time, which means Well Met is going to go for the Stitches pickup, which I think is going to prompt a Brightwing pickup for We're Not Prepared.
Brightwing and something. The question is, what else will be going in here? I expect a Warrior, because they... Well Met's got the first dibs on Warriors, but they're going to
want... So Brightwing Arthas, maybe? Arthas. Yeah.
Yeah, on this something map, Arthas lines. Is pretty nice. And Brightwing is even nicer, so yeah, I expect so. On this map, I'm actually really a fan of Falstad, even more than before. It's going to be Brightwing and Tassadar.
Mm-hmm.
But not too surprising, as We're Not Prepared really do love picking that Tassadar. But on this map, Falstad was always good before because of his mobility and his ability to bribe. But now with his new ultimate, I would say, it's actually really good because you can buy enough time with that pushback to take a tribute.
What happens if you have Brightwing on one side and Falstad on the other, both doing the ultimate?
I don't know. Do they just
crush the heroes into molecules? And
I think I don't know. I think there was a show a while back, but I don't think it's been updated in a while. We need Heroes Mythbusters.
For sure.
And if that show is not continuing anymore, we need someone else to start up Heroes Mythbusters.
Pick it up. I love that for StarCraft.
Same. That was great.
All the fun stuff with Mothership, Chorus, and Nidus, and what do you call them again when the Infestors take over?
Neuroparasites.
Neuroparasites, exactly. All the fun stuff you could come up with.
Yeah,
we tried to do something like, well, I'm not going to go into StarCraft lore, or not lore, but rather stories from team games.
Yeah, it's fair enough. Muradin coming back up for Well Met, going for the double Warrior straight away. Denying all of it away from We Are Not Prepared.
So this is going to leave their assassins open now.
No one's picked an assassin yet.
Yeah.
No Tychus, no Valor.
It's got to be an assassin pick now for Well Met. It's got to be.
What,
or specialist. It's got to be a specialist or assassin pick up now for Well Met.
It won't be Nazibo. Nazibo's probably going to be picked this game, but he'll be left till last.
Yeah, you don't want to pick Nazibo in the middle or even the beginning. Yeah, otherwise, like, he's just going to be counterpicked.
Pretty much not. Well Met should almost not pick Nazibo, just as a guarantee there, because they've already taken both their warriors, and that leaves We Are Not Prepared with the perfect opportunity to grab an Anubarak.
Mm-hmm.
If they leave that open and don't reveal it in time.
But Well Met really loves to take their time.
They really do.
Yeah,
they're very patient with their picks. Hammer, now this I was going to talk about earlier, but I completely forgot. This is the best move they could have done. Because We Are Not Prepared have been relying on that Sergeant Hammer so heavily in these games, pulling it away from them and pulling them off their game. As long as Well Met can use it reliably, then they've just dealt a huge blow to the way We Are Not Prepared have been playing in these games.
Oh yeah, for sure. I do like that move. But I also like the move of banning Valor, because Valor has also been a solid pickup for Well Met. So it's both teams that will need to readjust their strategies here.
Yeah, both teams giving each other the mutual respect that they deserve. It's very nice to see.
For sure. Alright, the next pick goes to the way of We're Not Prepared.
Yeah.
And they should be going for their warriors now. But, like, well, really, no, to be honest, they can...
There should be one warrior and one assassin. Because they need to leave a second warrior open in case Nazibo comes in.
True, true. Or even just not go for the warriors just yet. And instead, go for double assassin, just single warrior for their last pick. But then...
Maybe. Well, Tassadar's kind of the pseudo-warrior fill-in. Because he survives huge amounts of time and still does decent damage. And the shields give him the likeliness of another warrior. And there we go. Falstad coming in because he is fantastic on this map. And combined with Brightwing, the flying bribe is pretty nice. And there's Arthas coming in And both teams very much have the viability of fitting a noob rack into their comp. Wellmet do not need it due to the Muradin long range stun and the Stitches mini stun if it is required. So they do not need a noob rack in their comp, so they can pick whatever they want here. And I wouldn't pick... in fact, I would pick Nazibo here because of how this comp is, but Brightwing Polymorph and the potential of a noob rack is still quite risky.
Yeah, I wouldn't like it too much. Do you think they're going to go for Thrall again?
I think they will. I think that would be one of their Thrall last Uther? Picks.
That would leave him very, very melee heavy, though.
True. I don't know. It's an interesting setup that they have here. They have their main damage dealer. They need a support and they need an assassin. So it is a very interesting comp. I'm very curious to see what they finish it out with, because I quite honestly, for one of the first times in a while, I don't really have any idea other than I do agree with you that Uther is probably the support.
That's okay.
Hey, oh, we're wrong.
Wow. We're not prepared.
They have left their composition open for an Anubarak if that's what they want to pick, but it's only Anubarak and the Brightwing Polymorph to interrupt. Okay.
Ooh, Tyrael? Okay.
That's risky. All right then. Okay. Fine. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to argue.
Tyrael, it's been about maybe 3 months that I've seen Tyrael.
If that's the case, they're not even going for the knockback. So the only interrupts here that they're going to be able to have for Nazibo is Polymorph and Tyrael himself with the Judgment.
Yeah.
So basically the idea is going to be Judgment Tyrael or Judgment Sergeant Hammer and then Shock and Awe them. But with the damage reduction onto Judgment, they're not probably going to be able to one-shot here.
No, I don't know.
And only two stuns on the team. There's no way they're taking the knockback from Falstad if they have a Tyrael on their team. This means that Nazibo is basically going to have free reign, and he already has a very solid front line as it is, which will only get better in the late game because of knockback mines. I am very dubious of this comp.
But I like the Eraser comp for Wellmet. Think about it. Stitches going for the hook. Malfurion immediately going for the root.
Root come first. Yeah. Root under Stitches.
Root onto hook. You have the zombie wall to follow it up. And meanwhile, Sergeant Hammer and Muradin just dishing out the damage.
Yeah, Muradin will also probably come in with the chain stun. Like, in my Hero League at the moment, my highest win ratio is with Uther. Because, mm-hmm. one, people don't like playing assassins. And two, Uther is... people don't like playing supports and love playing assassins. And Uther's kind of good with multiple assassins. And two, stuns are amazing. And every time I play over Stitches, it is my happiest day because I just follow him around, wait for him to hook someone and stun them the second they come in. And then they usually die.
Let's see if this is going to happen here. We don't have Uther, but we have Malfurion.
Yeah. Indeed. Well, in this case, Uther was replaced with Muradin. In terms of the stun the second they arrive from the hook.
Seeing that advice, never 1v1 Thrall.
Yes.
Like you said, I've read that multiple times already.
It's a terrible idea.
It's like you Shen way back. Oh, come on, Zaka, why do you guys always take 2-minute breaks?
Like, Shen can 1v1 Thrall early, but once you get to late game, you're not getting away with it. Because Wind Fury does out damage the shield barely, but when you get to late game and if you take the triple hit, you're going to be doing it for you're going to be doing so much damage and you will out damage the chain shield. So, yeah, mm-hmm. Those two are pretty even. I'd like to see a 1v1 between those two just to see what would happen.
Old Chen?
No, new Chen. Because there's no way that the only way that Fra would be able to interrupt the Panda Bros is with Sunder.
Hmm. Okay. So, what do you think about Winner Prepared's composition here?
I like it, but I think it's out of date.
Yeah,
is my best.
Pretty much my understanding of their composition. But I mean, then again, if you're putting out Tyrael, you at least have some kind of idea behind it. You don't really throw him out if you're just going in blindly.
Yeah, I would agree. Currently, we have 7 out of 10 players ready up, so we can get into game as soon as possible.
Check the bracket. Maybe we have more updates. It's been a while. Nope, nothing
no,
yet.
The guy in the Skype has told us that he will be keeping us up to date.
Oh, sweet. Okay, so it's up to us if we want to switch to the lower part of the bracket later on. What do you think?
As much as I think the teams are interesting, I think we're going to be here for a bit too long if that's the case.
Yeah, no, we're not doing both semifinals. That would be nuts. But just we could go, instead of following this semifinal in the upper part, we could go and switch to the lower part.
No, I think the semifinal here is going to be too interesting.
Yeah, I think so too.
Like, well, we get to cast the third place match anyway, because we don't cast the finals.
Exactly.
So I think
it's good. We'll see one, at least one of these teams. Mm-hmm. And then we will see the other one in the regular playoff or the regular season.
Yep. We have 9 out of 10 readied up now. And we can hopefully get started soon once the last person is readied up.
Is it just Sake? That's not.
It's always Sake. Every time.
Why does. Oh, he's probably going for a smoke break.
Yeah. There we go. He's asking everyone else if they're ready. That's why they're ready, Sake.
Born ready. Let's do it. Countdown has started. You know what I like?
What
match
you like?
Countdown reduced to 5 seconds.
Yeah,
not 10.
That's nice. Wait, was it ever 10?
No, but for StarCraft 2 it was. And it just takes forever. Yeah. Doesn't really help all that much either. But
it has helped me a couple times where
just cancel out.
And someone like, stop! And you stop it and it's like, game speeds are normal.
No, I think most players don't actually know how to stop it, because like once in a while I ask to cast a game and then like, oh wait, well no, the countdown has started, I can't do anything about it.
No, you just leave lobby and it resets it. But we've had people stop countdowns before because game speed's been on normal and stuff like that. Stuff that's been set up wrong with the person setting up the lobby.
Alright, let's get into the final match here in this series between Wellmet, who has spawned on the left side as the blue team. We have Hysterica on Nazebo. Hasu Ops is playing someone that I can't really see, but Sergeant Hammer. Haruki is playing Malfurion. And Nomi is on Muradin, as always. Zake playing Stitches.
And on the right hand side, in the red trunks, it is going to be We Are Not Prepared. And starting in the top lane, it is Polator on the bright wing, like last game. Pretty consistent, it's Killer Chino once again on the Tassadar in the mid lane. And in the bot lane, it is Falcon playing a hero much more like his namesake in this case. I know it's a Griffin, but it's close enough. He is playing the Falstad. T-Darker is on the Tyrael, and Black Scorp returning to the Arthas.
So we'll have a look at Tyrael and his build. See what's happening here. Purge Evil is the first one. Smite deals more damage to heroes.
Yep, fairly standard, even before the changes were made. You like to get that little burst damage, and wow, engaging straight away onto Haruka, and he's down. Oh my god!
Wow, that's a lot of burst damage. That's the first blood going to We're Not Prepared.
That is a gank and a half. Jesus, that is... Wow, I think that's one of the quickest early deaths I've ever seen. They just ripped that guy. Alright, but... Sorry, I lost all professionalism there for a second. They're going in again. Black Scorp roots Hasselhoff. He is boosting out of there, but he goes down again.
Wow, with the Death Coil as the final blow. Jeez, that's We're Not Prepared on fire in the first 5 minutes here. Or first 2 minutes, rather.
Yeah, well met appear to be the ones who are not prepared in this case. We're seeing Sergeant Hammer head up to the mid lane because she realizes, okay, this is going to be a problem. And we're seeing Nazebo head up there as well. They are moving their party lane to the top lane so that there's at least one less direction they can be ganked from.
Maybe this is something that We're Not Prepared have actually waited for. For them to take Sergeant Hammer and not know how to play her.
Oh, it's okay. Also, God, this gank squad is amazing. This is very back in the day. Gank squads have fallen out of fashion a bit.
Yeah.
But We Are Not Prepared. Sure. Starting the game with 3 kills, giving their team a level advantage. 3 kills before the 2-minute mark.
That's really insane, to be honest. Does give them a nice little XP boost, and they've not really... Ooh, Hammer is in trouble again, but misses the root. Nice boost.
Even the tire tread there. Able to get out of there, though. And now, we're seeing We are not prepared. Already just going to take their hard cap. They can do it with these two, with the combination of the shield and Arthas' self-heal thanks to his death coil.
Yeah.
He is going to be pretty fine taking this. Easy cap being taken by Well Met here, but Well Met very much on the back foot here. They're almost a full XP bar behind. First tribute, though, does spawn in the Well Met party lane, so they are pretty set up for this.
Yeah, but still, I think that when I prepared, they could go for that. Oh, Zocca clearing the right side there. And looks like they're just gonna let it go. They took the camp. Let's see. But no, this is a way too good of a hold here for Well Met. And ooh, Channeling Disrupted, but Tyrael, not bad.
Yeah, Tyrael,
they don't have all
good.
Players
his
up there.
Too, his Eldwin's Might can harass for a very, very long time, and he can teleport in as well. He wants to, yes, exactly like that.
Wow, that is insane.
He's gonna probably end up giving his life for this, unfortunately, unless he can get out. Oh, Brimwing's coming in, and the Tassadar heal as well. Darker TPing out, but gets pulled back out of the zombie wall. He might have gone down if they'd left him in there, but Stitches reacting a bit too quick there and pulling him out of the zombie wall. But finally,
nice move by both.
Gonna be able to grab this.
Yeah, nice move here by both Killochino and Appellator for jumping in, giving the shields and of course the heal to keep him alive. And look at these towers, they're already run out of ammo and they're dishing out the damage. One of the towers will fall here, the gate is also in trouble, but for now, Nomi, Zake and Hiroki can push it back.
Yeah, this is true. Hasselwob's doing so much damage here in this top lane, he's already taken out literally everything up here.
Yep, lots of siege damage, 12,000 siege damage, but also, wow, look at that, Felstead, 23,000. It's not bad at all. Meanwhile, Tyrael is the real hero killer here with 2,000 hero damage done already. Let's have a look at his third talent, it's Battle Momentum, of course.
Yeah, Battle Momentum, pretty nice ability here. Tyrael, so much damage, this is a bit of a different build to what we usually see. But it appears to be working. He's going to be very low on... If he was in a lane with this build, he would be very low on mana very quickly. But because he's using it for ganks, it's working very well. Black Scorp, though, going to be stunned. This gank shut down very quickly by Nomi. So we're going to instead see... we are not prepared. Set up for another... set up for the next tribute. And I would like to point out, it's still 3-0 because Tyrael was able to escape when they were denying that tribute.
Yep, and this tribute should go to We're Not Prepared. Yep, no contest coming out of Well Met whatsoever. So 1-1 in the tribute game. And they're setting up the next gank. They're just luring Hiroki out. Let's see, can they make it happen? One of the towers is already down, so Hiroki can't really hide here. Let's look at the root. Oh, there's... Oh, nice
gone.
Move.
He's gone. So much burst damage coming down. They're going to take a tower for this. Likely take a fountain as well, but the Bruiser Cap is there, so they need to be careful that they don't get caught out here. Black Scorp, already. Black Scorp ignoring the fountain, gonna go to work on that fort, getting damage done. Nomi does get a stun off, gonna continue stacking his way up. He's currently on, hang on, I've forgotten how to count. He's currently on, I think, 10 stacks? 8 stacks, sorry.
Yeah, it looks like they're not gonna quite go for that fort, but took out the mana well. And that's the next tribute coming up, and they're already in a pretty great position. Maybe they can stop Nomi before he actually gets there. Nope, nice stun here on Black Scorp.
Yeah, Black Scorp, though, with the huge body and the Tassadar shield, is going to be able to tank this area for quite a while. Falstad is going to be joining them soon. He's going to be the slowest of the fight, though, but Brightwing is here as well. Black Scorp is already starting to tank before Falcon even gets there. There is the silence coming out from Hiroki. There is the Ravenous Spirit coming out, but nice Polymorph did save it for Hysterica. And down goes Stitches. He is the first death. So many shields here for the members of We Are Not Prepared. And they take down Muradin as well. Killochino just harassing from afar, but it's far too late. Darker has already taken this tribute for We Are Not Prepared. Black Scorp tank all the way through this.
Yeah, 2-1 for tributes, and looks like they're gearing up to take their boss. Meanwhile, Well Met, they had to port back and also deal with the trouble in the bot lane, so Malfurion did go down there. That's 0 kills so far for Well Met. That's not something they're used to. They're used to winning these team fights, and it's frankly a situation they've never really had in all the pro games I've cast for them.
Yeah, fair enough. Someone is apparently saying this is the usual Tyrael build. I haven't seen Tyrael in a while. I might be wrong. Yeah. If you are correct, then I apologize. And we are seeing Judgment with its cool new icon with the beta release. It's also being brought in.
Cast aside is his next talent here. Smite pushes enemies outside of the target area.
A good idea. So nice little,
good zoning potential with that.
It's extra CC, because that can interrupt Nazibo.
Ah, okay. Not bad.
Yeah, and he may take the impassable area as well for the same reason, which will be the next level. And right now, we're not prepared. Already at this tribute area, Falcon going to start taking Politor, looking to interrupt, but you can't interrupt spiders. They will keep the harassment there to stop the tribute being taken. Darker going to be moving in. Hasselwobs, though. This harassment from Well Met can go on for quite a while. The combination of spiders that can't be stopped. Hooks from Zoke and the napalm. But
oh, there comes the judgment.
Combo. Hysterica goes down. And that's the combo we were talking about earlier. And apparently, like I said, it might have not been a one-hit kill if it was just Judgment and Shock and Awe. But when you combine the entire team going onto that guy, he's going down.
Yep, and that's the next boss going their way. Nice little steal here. And let's see, what is Well Matt reacting? They're trying to take down the top fort, but I think we're not prepared. They can actually go for the counter-aggression here. Oh, Sergeant Hammer is in trouble.
Yep, Sergeant Hammer is in trouble there, but he's going to be able to boost out in time before he gets caught, and even a slow from the Hammerang out of Falcon, or the root coming from Arthas there. My mouth just derped out a bit, but I fixed it.
Oh geez, I'm kind of worried. Why is Well Matt actually doing this counter-aggression right now? Usually you'd go for defense, but instead they're going for that top fort.
It's very unlikely that the keep will go that we are not prepared will get the keep here. They're in fact going to have to stop here if they want to survive. There's
the nice gorge.
But there's the root actually stopping him from pulling too far back, but Darker is still going to die here, and down he does go. Yeah, that was a good move by Well Met, because they were able to get the counter aggression done, get a fort, which gives them a bit of XP, and they knew that there is no way that We Are Not Prepared would be able to kill everything quick enough to take down that middle keep. So they just gave themselves a little bit of XP, some counter aggression to get something done, but they're not going to be able to save their top fort, which is going to put We Are Not Prepared even more firmly in the lead and completely nullify that counter aggression that Well Met did. It was the correct move, but We're Not Prepared are just still too far ahead already.
Yeah, that's top fort going down, and a two-level advantage already, and this is a very vital level. Level 16 talents. Let's have a look what they actually taken here. Stone Skin, Blood for Blood, Overdrive, Critterize, and Second Strike. So no real surprises. And that gives them a solid advantage in the next teamfight.
Yep, Overdrive going to be fantastic here. We've seen it before. We've seen it many a time. Overdrive into Shock and Awe, and everything dies. The Giant Killer is a bit interesting. At level 13, though, it's taking the place of what would be Rewind. Unless I'm mistaken, Rewind was not removed from Falstad. I might be incorrect, though.
I don't know. Not certain here.
But
Giant Killer does help out quite a bit in these team fights, then.
Especially considering the comp they are against, where there's Muradin and Stitches, it is a lot of extra damage.
Why are they taking out the walls here? I don't really get it. They don't give XP, right?
No, it's remove vision.
Oh, okay.
Ah, the walls give a circle area vision. Taking them out doesn't really gain you anything except stopping the team know where you're coming. And even with the bonus damage on cores, it's still very possible to die to a back door. And if you take down the walls, it at least removes the chance of that. It means they have a lot less places to hide, and you'll see them coming. They won't see you coming from a bit further away. And there is a tribute spawning. Tyrael going to be a bit late there, choosing to take the watchtower before he makes his way down. And however, Well Met are going to kill this minion wave first before they head down, which means they're going to be even later to this tribute. Tyrael actually arriving before them. And Well Met even
I think this is going to be 1-1 again in the tribute game here. LexCorp hiding on the left side, trying for Well Met to make the move. It's not going to happen. 1-1 in the tribute game. It's all going to start over.
Yeah, I think so. And I don't get why Well Met didn't try to contest there, but I guess with the level disadvantage, they're just playing it safe. And right now, doing the opposite of playing it safe, they made their way towards the boss count, because that's what they thought the enemy was. And now they're kind of out of position. They're going to need to try and engage here. They get
oh, nice hook on Blackhawk.
Choosing the gore instead of let the brute take effect. And out it did take Relentless, so we came out early. There's the Ravenous Spirit. And that's still going down. But Tyrael interrupts it with the cast aside. Like we said, is possible here. Nomi taking no damage. No one is currently dead. Darker is very out of position, though. He's having to retreat. And that will probably stop this fight from continuing. Oh, Darker, he's still out of position. There's the napalm. Can he TP over the wall? No, he can't. Darker goes down, and he is the only casualty of this fight. And that brings the kill count still, though, up to 2-7. And both deaths on the side of We Are Not Prepared have been Tyrael.
No surprise there. But that's also due to the way he plays. I mean, just think about it. His passive ability with a bomb, being himself, being the bomb himself, just kind of alludes to the fact that he can die a lot.
People are telling me that Rewind is definitely gone on Falstead. I have not been keep. Yes, there's a lot of patch notes. I guess I missed that one.
Oh, this is a nice move though for Well Met. They're going for the boss, they're grabbing that second tribute, and even taking the Bruiser Camp here on We're Not Prepared side. So a really nice move, and now they're trying to lure them out since they need to react to that boss.
Yep.
Maybe a good hook out of Socket, and there comes Hook and Gorge. Arthas gets put out.
So good, able to keep over, able to get out of there very quickly. The shields keeping him alive. He's trying to dash out, gets the speed boost from Brightwing, turns around, activates his ult, and is going on to Nobi. There is the judgment onto Hasselhoff. There's so much heals. First aid pop, but Hasselhoff still being dropped low, and he's able to get out alive. Still no deaths currently. Socket is now the one being chased. He is being dropped quite low. The slow is still coming in from Blackstorm, and Socket turning to run the opposite way to try and slow down the enemy team.
So it's a 4v5 now for this final tribute. This could be the final tribute here for Well Met, but I don't think they're going to go for it. They have no chance. So it's going to be 2-2 in the tribute game, unless they can get a good disrupt off, but I doubt it. Yep, Brightwing almost done here. Yep, that's the next tribute going to We're Not Prepared.
Yep, this is the case. They're going to be moving down, though, to try and take this golem. And this could be Well Met's chance to try and get some counter damage. Top keep just went down, but We Are Not Prepared. Not paying attention there. That just died to minions. But they're taking the mercenary. They're taking the golem here. This is Well Met's chance if they can get in quick enough, but they are not ready. And the napalm gives them the vision in time to see it's already gone. Oh, Darker, that was not a wise move, but Well Met still not choosing to engage.
Yeah, luckily not capitalizing on it. Otherwise, he could have been caught out there. Ooh, they're going for the Bruiser Camp.
Oh, this is a risky move. Socke doesn't get the hook, though, and Blackscope still gets it. And he's going to be able to get out as well, back to Tyrael heals. Managing to root down Nomi and Stitch there, and they get out again. And they're in the perfect position.
The final tribute.
Tribute while they have boss, while they have bruisers.
That is insane.
Looking like a good, looking like they're gonna be able to take this.
Yeah, they could finish this game right here. Bruisers are still in the mid lane. The boss is wailing away at the core, taking out some of these shields already, and it's still going strong. And now the entire team is moving into the mid lane. Keep already taking a lot of damage. There comes the zombie wall on Black's Corp, and now they're jumping on top of him. Nomi with the body block. There comes the Shock and Awe on the left side. Not doing all that much, but Black Corps, he's taking a lot of damage. Maybe they can push him out. Hasu Ups being pulled inwards, and he might go down here. Black Scorpion is on his back, but he does get away. Wow, Well Met still in control of this, and they take out Brightwing. Everything could snowball now. The hook misses barely, and it looks like We're Not Prepared is getting out of that fight.
We're Not Prepared. Losing the Brightwing, but they did not finish the game with this curse as we expected. The core, though, for Well Met, already very low. I apologize for being distracted there. I just got a load of messages, and I have not set myself to busy. I just got messages from a load of players taking the mick out of me for not knowing that Rewind has gone from Falstead.
Oh,
apparently,
well.
It's something everyone knows. Who knew? I struggle to keep up with everything at once. I apologize.
Well, so many patch notes.
So it's many right, patch notes. It took still, an hour to read them, guys. An hour.
We're Not Prepared. That was actually really surprising. I mean, Well Met, they really put up a really, really good fight there. I did not expect them to actually win that fight.
If they had lost that fight, they would have been in some serious trouble. So, I'm really worried about this. But we're not prepared. Right now, they're hiding, waiting for a pick. But, well met. Choosing not to head into the mid lane, which would be a suicidal move at this point. Instead, heading to the bot lane to take care of those mercenaries. However...
And keep in mind, now that they do have two tributes, the next tribute is really vital for them. They could still make a turnaround happen, but they always need to watch out for... for backdoor attempts out of Winner Prepared now. Here comes the Siege Camp. It's step one of the setup.
Yep, Stitch's Hook just flies in from the bottom of my screen there, does not catch anyone. Winner Prepared moving into their own Bruiser Camp, and they are playing it very, very safe at this point. They just had a fight that wasn't the best fight they could have had, so they are taking down everything they can at this point. They're just going on the map. There's killing minion waves to make sure that their top lane is a bit safer because they lost the keep there. They're taking mercenaries to make sure that they have the lanes pushing. Well met though, moving into the boss, they thought that's what was being done, but it's not being done yet because they didn't have everyone there. They were busy on other places of the map. And the Oracle from Tassadar sees that Well Met is already set up here. And we may see a team fight, and this could be what decides the game. If not, and it doesn't look like it is because both teams have disengaged, we're going to be seeing the next fight at the next tribute, probably, because there's no way that We Are Not Prepared can let Well Met take another tribute, because that could be them letting the game slip through their fingers. We Are Not Prepared, though, grabbing this golem, and that's going to be a huge advantage for them, and then they're going to head down to contest that tribute. It's on their side of the map. Well, no, it's about even.
Well,
slightly
it's
more
secondly difference. In the middle. Yeah, sure thing. The thing is, Well Met is almost in position already. Nomi's going to start channeling straight away.
They cannot. Oh, they're nowhere near in time to interrupt that.
Yeah, that's not going to work. That's the third tribute going to Well Met. They might make a turnaround happen now. They're going to port back first. They know they're in trouble. They could just bypass everything here, but no, that's not going to happen. We're not prepared, not going for that just yet.
Indeed, Claris is in the chat. Hello, Claris. Golem going to continue pushing at the top lane and do some huge damage. And that is basically going to be what keeps We Are Not Prepared in this game. That Golem is stopping Well Met from pushing down the lanes and doing huge amounts of damage. Their mid lane still being pushed by minions, and their bot lane would be joining it soon. The core is doing a good job of dealing with holding its own in the top lane. And that's what is keeping We Are Not Prepared in this game. Golem has just spawned in this bottom lane. And I think We Are Not Prepared.
They're setting up a trap here.
That's so risky.
They're setting up a trap. Nomi hasn't spotted it just yet, and there he goes.
Here it comes. Shock and Awe hits three members there. The Nazibo is in the back doing huge amounts of damage. No one can get to him. He's going to get his full duration off. And Well Met, I think, are going to be able to take this fight. Down goes Muradin. In comes the Judgment from Darker. Hasselwops is still in the back dealing huge damage. It looks like I might be wrong. Hasselwops cannot boost down to their Black Scorp and Killer Chino take him down. Killer Chino is out, though. And that is two members for each team. That turns out to be a draw. Falcon is so low, but no one can catch him at this point. Darker, on the other hand, is being harassed by Moonfires from that Malfurion. They can't catch him either, but they are able to take down Tassadar and make it a 3-for-2 in favor of Well Met, and they're going to use this opportunity to try it.
Darker, he's still in trouble. From the left side, Hiruki comes in.
Oh, the Moonfire! Shields come out! There's the Root! The Root takes him down! Hysterica, though, taking damage from the Fort here, takes damage from the Tyrael. It's a lot of unnecessary damage, but Well Met now very much back into this.
Oh, of course they have been. That's 4-2, and now these teamfights actually matter as far as timeouts are concerned. Still 10 seconds on Brightwings and almost 50 seconds on Tyrael, so they're gonna go for their boss now. Finally go grab that. Luckily for them, We're Not Prepared actually didn't go for it just yet.
The issue with taking this boss now is it's gonna be pushing in the bot lane where there's still a fort up. But I would like to point out, two forts are up for We Are Not Prepared, but that means when Well Met rolls in and kills them, they are gonna start getting a pretty big XP lead. They already have an XP lead at this moment in time, and there's still two forts worth of XP for them to basically farm.
Yeah, it's true. They can still get a lot of XP out of these guys, and then possibly get an XP or level lead here. They're not quite in that spot, and with one keep down, well, one keep down on both sides, so... Well, actually, two keeps down for some reason. No, wait, never mind.
Nope, still one keep down for each team.
Yeah, one keep down. I was just confused as hell.
Yep, Golem takes down the bottom four, and the team of Wellmet are gonna roll into that mid lane and take that down. Also grab the towers to give them even more of an XP lead, and they have a very large XP bar now in their favor, and they're gonna continue pushing this. Not for the kill, probably, but just to get some preliminary damage down. I doubt they'll be able to get towers here, because as we can see, we are not prepared, reacting to this, already on their way up there. Well met, though. Gonna start positioning themselves. Nice napalm for vision there. They can see that we are not prepared, are not following them down. Tribute spawning right next to Well Met here, and they're gonna set up for this. And if I was Riot Up prepared, I would ignore this. They need to defend. It's only one tribute. You might as well let that one go, I think.
Yeah, and it's the first tribute, too. They're still preoccupied dealing with these siege giants. They're obviously going to lose their Bruiser camp as well, so it's still going to hurt a little bit more, even so, but they had no chance in really contesting this, so it does make sense to not go for it at all. Still a little bit of prancing back and forth between these guys. We've not seen a team fight in a while.
Yeah.
And I don't think it's going to happen unless...
I don't either. I think both teams are just going to continue this and just take mercenaries when they can. We're going to have to see Wellmet either push the advantage they have right now and win another team fight, or force another team fight, or we will see another sort of light skirmish where We Are Not Prepared comes out on top and they start taking their lead back. And we're just going to continue this dance. However, We Are Not Prepared look like they want to force something here, moving into this bush, possibly to try and roll into this bruiser camp. Golem's nowhere near up. They're heading a very long way around if they're going for the bruisers. There's a tribute.
Yeah. Oh, I think they're waiting for the tribute, yep. They knew the tribute was going to go up.
Prediction. If people know... Have people worked out the tribute spawn? As far as I was aware, it was still...
Yeah, it's been worked out. And I think it's been changed again, but Ali just checked out the undocumented patch notes and figured out that there's something new to it. I didn't really get into it just yet, but it used to be three columns, and I think... either top or bottom, so three columns, two rows. Then the first one would always spawn in a random location, then the ones after that always spawn in the top, and then afterwards in the bottom, and one of the columns, and never the same one. But I think they changed the rules again.
I was about to say, that sounds very complicated.
It's not as complicated. If you see a sketch of it, it makes sense.
Okay, is he the one who did the video of it? So there was a video on Reddit,
that was Lauren, I think.
Ah, yes.
Some US player. Or fair maybe enough. Soldier? I don't know.
Might be. I think it was Soldier. That rings a bell video-wise. But right now, we are seeing both teams just doing the exact same thing as we said they'd be doing. Just both taking mercenaries, avoiding each other as much as possible.
For sure. By the way, I just want to back up that fact, what you said before, Nazibo being an assassin, really. 56,000 hero damage.
Yeah, that says it for itself. He has more than Sergeant Hammer. And that's what these two do. They're both specialists, but they take the role of assassins. And there's other specialists that take the role of pushers. And there's other specialists. And then there's Murky.
Maybe they should redesignate those things. Oh, nice trap set up here for Winner Prepared. Zocca moves right on top of it. Can he get the gorge off?
Chuck it all onto Sokke. Sokke blinks away though to take Blackscorp into the backline though. That might not be a bad idea because now Blackscorp is onto Hysterica. Hysterica using Spirit. Now goes the Ravenous Spirit onto a lot of members and it's doing decent damage. Falcon having to back up and he's now completely out of fight. But two members are already down for Well Met. And this is what I said might happen, where we are seeing the members of Well Met go down in another fight. Nomi is still alive though. In comes Falstead. He's going on to Hastuob. He's pulled out the overdrive. So much damage being popped down, but he can't finish him. And we're also seeing Sokke is able to get out alive. Nomi is surviving in the backline. But this is the opportunity that we are not prepared looking for. It's 3 versus 5. And they're going for the
nice polymorph.
Trying to take him down. The shield is down. The core is going down. And it looks like it's going to be We Are Not Prepared moving on to the semi-finals at one step closer to qualifying for Season 2. commiserations to Well Met. Put up such a great fight, but just another team fight where they weren't able to do it. I think that was a bad move from Stitches, blinking into the back line with the Arthas, who's just going to immediately focus your main damage dealer.
You don't really want to do that. You don't really want to do that.
It's like what Stitches have done. I can't remember which tournament. I think it was last qualifier, in fact, where a Stitches hooked in a Ufa, who immediately divide Hurricane the entire team, and everyone just turned around and started.
That's
fighting.
Exactly what happened. that's one of the do's and don'ts with Stitches that you got to stick to.
Yeah, don't hook it. If you could avoid it, don't hook Ufa, or at least make sure you're slightly separated from your team, and don't bring someone into your back line if you have an Azebo there.